Narastro, first of all, thank you for your response for my Hindi English book of Nakshatrapadas. Now the Hindi book has been also been released. The book contains first 9 nakshatras and the story of 36 padas. The first 36 padas, where the Lord Shiva is talking to Ma Parvati, that has been explained. It's a decoded version of the Karam Vipak Samhita. That what in today's world it actually means. So that has been released. You can buy the Hindi version. The English version is already there. The Hindi version has also been released 2 days back. You can buy the Hindi version from this White Falcon store. And let us start our topic, eclipses. So today's topic, solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse is on 30th of November. Solar eclipse is in the mid of December. So when these two eclipses are happening, usually it's a gap of 15 days, because when the lunar eclipse happens in one sign, the moon travels 180 degrees and then the solar eclipse happens. Now when the solar eclipse and lunar eclipses are happening, how you can use this particular transit, because this is a transit event, in your charts to predict something. There's a very snapshot prediction you can use, which I'm going to teach you today. Usually these eclipses, if you read the Brihata Samhita, eclipses are mentioned. There's a complete chapter on eclipses, that what happens when the eclipse forms in this particular nakshatras, this particular sign, and how different parts of the country gets affected. These are used for the mundane events. Similarly, you can use the same particular technique in your chart to see what is happening in your life. For example, this time the axis is 2-8. The lunar eclipse in sign of Taurus, solar eclipse in sign of Scorpio. Last time the event was in sign of Gemini, solar eclipse was in sign of Gemini. So how you can see what is going to happen, whether it's a good event or a bad event, because eclipses are not always bad. Sometimes, because during the eclipse, what happens is there is a sudden release of the energy. Something bound to a very transformative state is there. Something new is about to start. It can be for good, it can be for bad. Depends on your chart configurations. So let's suppose, like last time it happened in the sign of Gemini, and if you have a Gemini badly placed, like in 6th, 8th and 12th house, and the 12th lord is in 7th, so you know some losses due to your partners is about to happen, because the eclipse has fallen in the 12th house. Suppose you have a planet placed in 12th house, Saturn, Mars, Rahu, whichever, that planet will also start giving you sudden results. This is the effect you can see. Now, what lunar eclipse tells and what solar eclipse tells us? Lunar eclipses is the seed of the event. See, whenever the lunar eclipse happens, always notice the transit of moon after that particular date for next 15 days. These are the small events, seeds of the events. That is why when people use the Shravana year, 360 days, lunar months, what they look in Dasha is the seed of the event. For the solar people who use mean motion of sun, 365.27 days. The people who use that particular Dasha scheme, that particular timing, they use the actual timing of events. Sorry. They use the actual timing of events using the days of sun. So this is the difference between sun and moon. So moon will give you a very good idea in the next 15 days that these are the events you can expect after the solar eclipse. Now, when the solar eclipse will happen in the sign of Scorpio, and your Ma and Scorpio is well placed in your chart. Let's suppose Scorpio is in 5th house, 9th house, 10th house, 2nd house, wherever Scorpio is. Look where the Mars is. If your Mars is well placed in the chart, because this particular solar eclipse is happening in the Gadant area, it's just on the end of the Scorpio. If your Mars is well placed from the sign Scorpio, like your Mars is not in 6th, 8th and 12th from Scorpio, it means that particular eclipse is not going to be that little bad. But let us suppose your Mars is placed in sign of Sagittarius. Now you know something related to money, because Sagittarius is a second sign, Mars is placed there. Something related to money is about to happen. Also, you have to see where the house is, which place the house it is in. So when you use this technique, wherever the eclipse is happening, use that with the house lord. You can use nakshatra lord as well. Virat Samhita uses the nakshatra lord, but not to make it complicated. What I've seen is, when you use the sign lord, it gives you very good results in predicting the events. Let's suppose Scorpio is in 12th house, Mars is placed in 9th. So some expenses related to father, related to travel, education is about to happen. This is what the this particular eclipse is going to bring you. But if this particular combination is related to your 10th house, because 10th house, whenever the eclipse happens in the 10th house and 10th lord is good place, some kind of power, achievement you're going to achieve. Like 10th lord in 5th house, one of the classical textbooks says the person will live very happily with its kids and enjoy their life. Because 5th house is for enjoyment. So when 10th lord is placed in 5th house, it also does not mean only power and position. It also means that after that, your life will become very comfortable. There are US presidents who got president after the eclipse fallen on their ascendant degree or the 10th house cusp. So if it is falling, this particular eclipse is falling in somewhere in the powerful houses and that house is very well placed, you should not worry about it. Because what the eclipse does is it releases sudden energy, and these energies when get released, it gives you results. It gives you very good results. But at the same time, when they are badly placed, the negative effects also continue. To nullify the malefic effects, as said in Akbarnama, as told by Sri K. N. Raoji in his book of Mundane Astrology, the people should donate the significations of the planet of where the eclipse is happening. Like this one is happening in sign of Scorpio. So lords are Mars and Ketu. You should start after the eclipse, donate the articles of Mars and Ketu to the temple, to the poor, to nullify the malefic effects of this particular transit. So even if it's falling in bad house, don't worry about it. You should go to temple and say, okay, I'm going to donate this much, whatever you're capable of, to nullify the effects. This is a very simple remedy anyone can perform. If you can make your own remedies, when I say make your own remedies, every chart has a different, because it does not matter how many combinations you will see in a chart, there will be always a chart which will have a different combination. Like Mars is placed in a particular house, then there's Jupiter is aspecting, the remedy will change. You should change a little bit of that remedy. Saturn is placed with it, or the sign is different. But a very general remedy, if you think you have a very badly placed Mars, please donate the articles of Mars. What is the article of Mars? You can donate Jaggery. You can pray to Lord Hanumanji, do Hanuman Chalisa, Sundarkand. People, lot of people do Sundarkand every day. Some of you do on Tuesdays and Saturdays. You can do Sundarkand to nullify the bad effects of Mars. But also donations are must, because what donations do is they take off the bad, negative energy, whatever you have acquired, and it starts giving you positive effects. So donations are must in these cases. Even in the Akbarnama, Akbar says that after this particular eclipse, I donated this much amount of the grains, gold, silver to the poor people to nullify the effect of the malefic effect of the grahan. It is similar, same as we mentioned in the book of by Sri Kiran Raoji in the Mundane Astrology. It's a very wonderful book to read too about the mundane. So this is the generalized remedy. But people who have a very good placement of Mars in their chart, like 10th lord in 9th house, 10th lord in 5th house, 10th lord in Lagna, they don't have to worry about it. Because what is going to give you this particular eclipse, what is going to happen is, all the pending work which was suddenly there, because what Sun Rahu combination does is, or Sun Ketu combination does is, it finds a way out. Because see, what problem with the sun is the planet, the first part of the sun is that whenever you see a strong sun in anyone's chart, you will not find that particular person unhappy. Reason being, because his moral standards are so high, He has always followed what needs to be done. That's what the son is. Son is when you help your enemies, even when you know they hate you. That's what the son is. Son is your moral compass, and it shows you what it requires to be done. But son has a boundary. Son draw rules. Son make charters, rule charters. And what Rahu and Ketu does is they do not follow it. They have their own, because see what Rahu is, it always focus on the final goal that I need to reach there. By hook or crook, that's why it's a kark of the sixth house. By debt, disease or enemies, I need to get this done. I want that nectar from Lord of Vishnu. Even I have to get change my appearance, I will still get it. That's what the Rahu does. So when Sun draws all these rules, Rahu says, do not worry about all these rules. I'm going to bypass them to get all this. So after the eclipse, what happens is you suddenly start getting ideas even before the eclipse, because the effect starts before the eclipse happens. You suddenly start getting ideas how I can get this done. How I can take off all these obstacles and achieve my objects. So this is what the Grahan does when it falls in a good place. You get ideas to solve your problems. So if you are having a very good combination of Mars in your chart, whether because in the sign of Scorpio it is happening, also it's a drainage. So Scorpio is a drainage where a lot of money goes out. So when an eclipse is happening in this particular sign, it's a very transformative sign. And if it is a good placement in your chart, do not worry. Just focus on the good part, see if your Mars is well placed, things will get all right. So I hope you guys have understood the technique. You will apply it on your chart, and see you guys next time. Thank you. Bye.